All right, guys, well, we're back on the bike here. I'm going to call this thing the YamaHonda project, I think. Basically, Yamaha bike with a Honda clone engine. So what I wanted to show you is we got the welding all done, and we went through and painted all the spots that we had welded and, you know, a few others as well. You can see it came out really well, actually. I'm really pleased with how we did here. One of the things I also had to do was the foot pegs were not correct for the way I liked them. They were straight down, and my foot pegs off the Yamaha are kind of on this angle here. So what I had to do was take these foot pegs brackets off, and then I had to rework my foot pegs so that they would fit onto these foot pegs so that the spring would work. And then I had to cut, you can see where there's a hole here where the dowel pin used to be up here, so the whole thing was turned so the foot peg wouldn't be flat. So what I had to do was cut this off, and then I turned it down and I put a new dowel pin in and welded it into place here so that now this is all held into place like it should be. And now the foot pegs are the more stout style here that the Yamaha came with. I think that's going to be a lot better than anything that would be straight down. That's not the way dirt bikes are done. Especially if you're going to stand up on this, you got to make sure you have a lot of strength here so you don't push those pegs down. So this is the way it should be. So I've modified that to fit. Okay, so what we're going to do now, as you can see, we got all of this done too. It's all nice and welded up. It looks really good. I think Master Outdoorsman did a really good job, and I was helping him here, directing him on the good places to weld, and we pretty much got it straightened out. So now we're going to put the engine back in, and we'll see what we need to do about getting the exhaust hooked up and the carburetor. So we're going to work on that next. All right, guys, well, we're in the thick of things here. We have the motor back in, everything lined back up again. That was good news. And I've been plumbing the exhaust here. Now, originally the exhaust would curve and go off on the other side of the motor. I was able to turn it. I have enough room here to bring it up around this way and reuse the original exhaust bracket here. We cut this off of the old pipe. I'm going to weld this onto here, and then we're able to bend this straight with the torches. And then I was able to use this coupler here, along with a piece of pipe here, to actually conduit into my old pipe, which we cut off. And then that runs off into the exhaust here. And I'm using this exhaust because it has a spark arrestor in it. And it also, the plastic all fits perfect when I put this on. So coming along pretty well. Right now we're working on the carburetor. We were able to get the carburetor back onto the engine directly, like I spoke about before. And I have enough room here for the cable, and everything's going to work just fine. It's going to be right in here. And right now Master Outdoors is working on a piece that's going to go from here to a K&N filter. It's going to be sitting right here. But it all fits in there really nice. So it's coming along real well. So I'll give you an update here in a few minutes when we get it together. All right, guys. Got the exhaust bent. And we got it connected to the old exhaust. Comes right out off the old muffler. And let me show you the carburetor. All right, so we were able to put the carburetor right on to the engine like I was showing. And I have this K&N filter right here connected right to it. It fits in here perfectly. We used the old boot from the old air box. So that fit right on here. And then we were able to fabricate up a piece of pipe in here to put the air filter on. Got the brake on. And everything seems to be hooked up now. I'm going to put the side covers back on and show you what that looks like. All right, well, there she is. What a beautiful thing. I'm really proud of what the my boys and I did here. Got the chain on there. Side covers are all back on. Got a little problem with the exhaust hitting the front fender. I'm going to get a new front fender, and we'll have to work on that. Didn't realize it was going to hit, but it does, so that's all right. Sure sounds good, too. Check it out. Almost looks like that motor was supposed to be in there, doesn't it? I think we did a great job. All right, well, I'm going to start it up and drive off and see what you guys think.